Everything starts at the beginning. This is the beginning.
Initially, I didn't know where the outlet of the now famous, or to some infamous, Umgeni Water Tongathi to Hazelmere pipeline is. I had to figure it out on a well-known earth-weighing program by examining the terrain to find the best possible position. It became clear that there was a bit of a ravine that stretched up from the dam towards the direction of Tongaat.
Ravines are mostly gorgeous.
The answer was somewhere on the Vincent Dickenson Road. With a bit of a gut feeling, I thus just got into my car and took off, hoping to be lucky. While traveling, I also discovered this dirt road that leads to the dam wall and decided to have a quick look. The view is good and nice, but dry like a good cider.
Cider? Now that you mention it.
It would have been lovely if water could have been gushing over the top in spectacularly cascade downwards, but not today. On the other hand, one only appreciates a drink if you have been really thirsty. The day when this dam wall overflows again would really call for celebration. The Hazelmere Dam was built in 1977 and it is a concrete gravity dam. The dam wall that you see here is 44 meters high and its length is 478 meters. The total capacity is 17.858 million cubic meters. It has a catchment area of 376 square kilometers. The surface area is currently much diminished, but it should be about 119 hectares at capacity.
After that, I'm definitely thirsty, as usual, of course.
On this 9th day of July 2015, the dam is down to 27.4%. Compare that to the 27.65% of the 6th, it means about 44.75 million litres left the dam on net between these two dates, notwithstanding all the incoming water. That amounts to about 170 litres per second net.
No, you don't confuse me. I don't listen.
The residents of this rural area come here to collect dead wood for the fires that they need for sustenance. They carry bundles and bundles of it for long distances to their places of residence.
I'm so over that damn wall.
So soon I found myself back on the Vincent Dickenson Road again. Two cars parked in the field away from the main road attracted my attention. This prompted me to investigate. Well, from the looks of it, this just could be it, if it wasn't perhaps just a burst water pipe. Water was shooting up in the middle of nowhere. It definitely needed to be investigated.
What are you spouting now, man?
A neat outlet has been built and the water was shooting from there. Niftily, it is projected upwards and rocks are built into the flow to break it up, and a rock cage bed is provided in afterflow to make sure the flow is soft enough to prevent unnecessary erosion of the embankment of the cliff. The drop is probably close to 30 meters and it is obvious that the slope carries on and that the water will rush to the dam, and it does, as I have found out. Watch my diary entry of the 15th of July if you want to see more. Down below, the water is streaming through the forest.
Chris on the rocks. Touching.
Let's go and have a quick look. We walk towards the dam just to get an idea. The water is clearly racing towards its goal. There are very little losses, just as with any other natural stream or river. The cost of extending the pipeline right down to the dam is clearly unnecessary in the light of the clear flow and minimal loss. The water is visible and flowing strongly. From this perspective, at the inflow into the dam, the water is coming roughly through the ravine that is marked by the smoke in the background. The actual flow is not visible from this angle, as it is hidden by the reach just behind the other side of the water surface in this direction. But it is definitely coming in, as I have seen the evidence. I was told that on the previous day, on the 8th, the pipeline pumped roughly 8 million litres of water towards the Hazelmere Dam. Convert it to litres per second and we get about 90 litres per second.
Now put that in your pipe and smoke it.
By implication, this should balance out if this high flow can be maintained. But a fair amount of water is also coming into the dam from the other direction via the Mshloti River. The Tongaat River was currently flowing at about 40 megalitres per second due to the rain, and there should be adequate water to sustain this for a while. Before the rain, some areas of the Tongaat as well as the sugar mill run dry because the Tongaat River just couldn't sustain the demand that was placed on it. It was itself affected by the drought, of course. Considering the time constraints, the Umgeni water pipeline was nothing short of a miracle, notwithstanding what its skeptics were claiming. Let us take a drive towards pump station number 1 to see what work was done in between. Maybe we can even have a look at the pump station.
Do I have to go?
The pipeline crosses under Vincent Dickenson Road and is dug in everywhere and neatly concealed and protected. On the other side of the road, it goes with the farmland service roads. It blends with farmland and sugarcane fields. The worked soil on our left is where the pipeline is concealed. Every now and then we find evidence of its existence at service access points. The number 1 pump station lies about 6 kilometers as the crow flies in a northeasterly direction from the outlet. The landscape is hilly and difficult to negotiate, and it makes sense to go with existing roads and to stay close to the streams wherever possible. It was built in a record time, and one just has to consider the complexities of such a project to begin to understand what it was that we dealt with. Normally, considerable time-consuming and costly expropriation of land has to take place for such a project to take place. I understand that more than 70 landowners gave permission for this project to commence on their land due to its urgency. They are the silent ones that we never give a cheer and a thanks. The engineering skills on this project had to acquire dire infrastructure, such as the pumps that were difficult to source, that had to be acquired to make a success of this project.
Impressive!
Close to Imona and north of Tongaat is a furrow in the Tongaat River that is the source of the water. And this is also where we find the pump station, just 100 meters away from it. Again, unobtrusive and concealed and neatly engineered, it fulfills its function, and that is to pump water to the Hazelmere Dam. Another pump station is found halfway to the dam as an auxiliary station to pump the water up the difficult terrain.
And this is the beginning of the end.
In the diary entry of the 15th of July 2015, we will look at the point of entry where the water from this pipeline enters the dam.
That's all, folks. Sorry.
Hi there, everybody. I go to places and tell stories of what I've seen. I tell them here. Take it on the rocks. Chris on the rocks. Collaboration is the name of the game for any vlogger. Many hours go into this. Give us your inputs and subscribe, please. Subscriptions makes this possible. We fade without them. We bloom and impress with support. Please like my videos and please share it to friends. Soon to follow will be regular postings on ship salvaging coming from my huge stock of video material that I've collected over 2 years. Many stories to tell. Also about the beauty of the world I live in. Meditations in nature, my style. Work together. This is going to be fun for all of us. Sometimes opinions as well. Views of the world. It will all be there. I want to show you my world as it is, and I hope it will be funny as well. In time, I want to have a one-size-fits-it-all channel.